What is a cDNA library? It is as many messenger RNA molecules as a cell can produce, cloned into plasmids, and then distributed into E. coli cells, or some other bacterium, but usually E. coli, such that each E. coli cell contains only a single version of the plasmid, which it then reproduces. So let's isolate total RNA from reticulocytes, the predecessors in our bodies of erythrocytes. And the reticulocyte is the place where the RNA for globins are transcribed and the globin proteins are produced. Our erythrocytes live about 60 days, carry out the functions of oxygen binding and delivery, and then they die. And they have to be replaced by new reticulocytes, which then lose their nucleus and then function as erythrocytes again. Well, we know how to get reticulocytes out of mammals, ourselves included. And if we isolate total RNA from a reticulocyte, which is, of course, still producing transcripts for their various proteins, we can put that RNA onto a little column containing gray stuff. Now, the gray stuff is synthetic. It's basically a bead to which has been attached a string of T's. You should remember that one of the things that happens to 99.9% of eukaryotic messenger RNAs is that as part of the processing, they get a poly-A tail of up to 200 A's. So if you have a solution of beads with oligo-d T or poly-T stuck on them, when you add RNA, the mRNA is going to bind or stick to those T's, and all the other RNAs are going to flow through the column. So here we have an illustration off to the left of polyadenylated mRNA sticking to the oligo-T's on the beads. So if that happens to the RNA you add to this column, what you collect then you can discard. That's non-poly-A RNA, which means it's not message, right? Mostly not message. It'll be the ribosomal RNA, the transfer RNAs, and so on, but it will not be message. After throwing away the stuff you don't want, you add a special buffer, destabilizing the H-bonds between the T's and the A's, and off comes the polyadenylated mRNA. We say it's eluted from the column. And so now we have poly-A mRNA in this test tube below the column. If we add reverse transcriptase to that solution along with 4-deoxynucleotide triphosphate precursors to DNA, we will synthesize reticulocyte cDNAs, copy DNAs. The process of making a single strand of cDNA into double-stranded cDNA is a bit complex, but it involves reverse transcriptase and some primers that go in the opposite direction. Again, it's a DNA synthesis reaction. Suffice it to say that you end up with double-stranded cDNA.